Hello, friends, and welcome into College Football Now. I am your host, Tom Downey. Time now for the AP poll just released to us. We'll break it down here for you guys. No changes in the top three, at least. Alabama stays at number one, Clemson at two, Notre Dame there at number three. Michigan at four, Georgia at number five. Oklahoma checks in at number six. West Virginia is at seven. Ohio State stays at eight. LSU slides on down as Washington State holds spot at 10. Outside the top 10 now into number 11 and beyond. UCF actually drops two spots. Talk more about that here in a second. Kentucky only drops one spot. Syracuse climbs way on up from 22 all the way up to 13. Utah State at 14. Texas stays at 15 because outside the top 15, it's kind of a mess overall, quite frankly. Fresno State's there at 16. Boston College slides up to number 17. Mississippi State is there at number 18. Florida slides way back from 13 down to number 9. Washington checks back in at number 20. Penn State tumbles down to number 21. And then four new teams that weren't ranked last week. NC State, Iowa State, Michigan State, and the University of Cincinnati. So those are your top 25. Here are the teams that are making their first appearance, frankly, in quite some time, at least for a couple of them. Washington, they check in and as they move into number 20 on the list. We'll get to those here in a second. NC State checks in at number 22. Iowa State at 23. The AP poll clearly responding to what the committee did in the first CFP rankings. Michigan State back in the top 25 at number 24. And then Cincinnati also back in the top 25 at number 25. Here are the five that left to make room for those. Utah, Houston, Iowa, Virginia, and Texas A&M all slide out of the top 25. They drop out altogether. Frankly, folks, once you get out to the top 10 or so, the parity in college football is pretty darn bad. Not a lot of good programs left, and I think you're going to see quite a bit of shuffling as we go along this year when we get outside that top 15. Utah, they plummet out if you're lost to Arizona State. Houston quickly falls out. Iowa, stop going to Purdue, I guess. Don't go to West Lafayette anymore, I guess is the overarching theme there if you're a Big Ten team and you're ranked. Virginia slides out, and A&M also slides out. So we'll get here back into the top 25 in just a second, but really no surprise here. Alabama, they should definitely be ranked number one. I don't think anyone have much discussion about that. And by the way, they are the unanimous number one team. Clemson remains at number two. Notre Dame, I think, is right at number three. It makes sense. You can't put Notre Dame ahead of Michigan or behind Michigan, right? Michigan won that one head-to-head. Georgia goes up one spot. I think well-deserved there. Oklahoma goes to number six. I think that makes a lot of sense as well. The one big change, and what frankly kind of surprised me a little bit overall, is that West Virginia, they make a slide here. They go from number 12, they go all the way into number 17. But folks, Georgia, Bama, I do want to have a quick question for you guys. With Georgia now set to play Alabama in the SEC title game, are they the most likely team to take down Alabama? Type one for yes, type two for no. Let me know what you guys think in the comment section. I think Clemson has the best chance, but Georgia, we know, is going to get a shot at least to beat them, which I think helps them out a little bit in terms of most likely. All right, Oklahoma checks in at number six. West Virginia slides way up. They go all the way into number seven. OSU stands pat at number eight. LSU stays at drops down to number nine. They remain ahead of Washington State. I'm kind of surprised that there's little respect right there for the Washington State Cougars. UCF, they drop, which is weird to me. They slide two spots. It's weird, right? I get that you want to move West Virginia ahead of them, but I'm really not sure what would cause UCF to drop behind Washington State. Would Washington State barely beat Cal at home? That doesn't really make a lot of sense to me. Either way, UCF falls out of the top 10 despite remaining undefeated. And then really after these programs, take your pick. Kentucky, Fresno State, Boston College, Texas is somehow 6-3 in the top 15 because it is a mess outside the top 11, quite frankly, in terms of the top college football programs. Florida, Mississippi State, it's all very confusing to me as to how exactly they're going to balance out these two programs. And by the way, Florida beat the Bulldogs. So why is Florida behind Mississippi State? It doesn't really make a whole lot of sense to me. You don't see many Pac-12 teams on there. They all kind of slid out. Washington State remains the best chance for the Pac-12. But will they have a team qualify for the 2019 college football playoff? For yes, it's plus 700 odds on BetDSI. No is minus 1,600. So the odds heavily favor a no. You can go bet on this right now, chatsports.com/bet. Use promo code LIVE120 for a 120% deposit bonus. What that means is put down 100 bucks. They'll give you 120 for free for a grand total of 220 to bet with on BetDSI. Again, folks, chatsports.com/bet. Promo code is LIVE120. All right, for those of you just now joining us here live on Facebook, the AP Top 25 just released. No changes at the top. Bama, Clemson, Notre Dame, Michigan, and then Georgia. Michigan, Georgia slide up with LSU sliding. The Tigers fall from 4 to number 9. Oklahoma stands pat. West Virginia takes a big leap, at least among the top 10 and top 15. They go from 12 to 7. OSU, the Cougars, and at 8 and 10 stand pat. UCF, which I don't understand, drops from number 9 to number 11. Kentucky drops just one spot, and then it's a mess. Syracuse goes way up, all the way up from number 22. They move all the way to 13. Utah State gets in the top 15. Texas stands pat at 6 and 3, but look at the teams behind them. Fresno State is 8-1. Boston College is 7-2. The Bulldogs are somehow ahead of Florida, even though Florida beat Mississippi State. Doesn't make any sense to me. Washington goes back in the top 20. They go to number 20. Penn State slides down to number 21. Michigan State jumps back in. NC State jumps back in. UC jumps back in. Iowa State makes an appearance at number 23. All right, other teams receiving votes. UC, by the way, had 141 votes. Utah's got 110. Auburn, they might be in the top 25 in the CFP rankings on Tuesday, by the way. They got 93, and then a big, big drop-off. Wisconsin, Army, give Bill Clark Coach of the Year. He has UAB 8-1, go figure, right? The formerly defunct UAB Blazers sitting there at 8-1. Northwestern, they're 5-4. Iowa, Boise, Purdue keeps getting some votes. How about Buffalo, the pride of the MAC right now, 8-1. Oregon, they slide in there, 6-3. They got a couple of votes. San Diego State, Duke, A&M, Houston. And oh, by the way, Texas Tech also has two votes, but that is it. So not quite the even fives there. I want to make note here of Clemson. Will they finish the season undefeated? You didn't see very many ACC teams on there. And if you look ahead at what Clemson has the rest of the season, their schedule is not that daunting. They do play Boston College. That's probably going to be their toughest schedule there, or toughest game left of the season. They also play Duke, which Duke has actually looked pretty solid so far this year. And then they also play South Carolina. I think you'll see Clemson go undefeated the rest of the season, at least in terms of the regular season. I don't think it'll be that daunting for them. I think they'll be in good shape. Now, Alabama, of course, remains number one at the top, and I think rightfully so. I don't think anyone's going to argue that after a pounding of a still top 10 program in LSU. UCF, I don't know why they dropped. I guess Kentucky's still a football school, ranked at number 12. Texas is still in the top 15, so teams that lost to higher-ranked programs didn't really slide all that much in the top 25 this week. Boston College stays there at number 17. They could provide a bit of a scare to Clemson coming up here. Florida, I don't know why they're behind the Bulldogs of Mississippi State, because they beat Mississippi State. That's confusing to me. They have the same record. Classic AP pollsters not understanding and forgetting what happened earlier on in the year. Penn State there, they're number 21. NC State, Iowa State, Michigan State, and Cincinnati round out the top 25. All right, folks, today's show is brought to you by Tavor. If you love craft beer, you're going to love Tavor. Head over to Tavor.com. Sign up is free. You'll get alerted about all of their great craft beers. There's going to be a lot of great winter beers coming up on Tavor. Promo code ChatSports, by the way, gets you $10 off your first purchase. All right, a couple of games we want to preview in what is frankly a down week this week around college football. How about Mississippi State against Alabama? Bama going to be heavy favorites in this one. The Bulldogs, maybe they can put a bit of a scare into Alabama, but it is a home game for the Tide. I got Alabama. I don't care what the spread is. I got them covering as well. I don't think you'll see a letdown game for the Tide after a big win over the Bulls, or after LSU. All right, next up, Clemson, Boston College. Maybe the last true test for the Tigers in the regular season. They go on the road. Game day is going there to Boston College. I got Clemson. It could be a bit of a trap game, even though it is a ranked opponent, but I'm curious to see what that spread ends up coming in at later on this week on BetDSI. And then Georgia-Auburn. I will not be surprised if when the committee reveals their new top 25, if Auburn actually checks in the top 25 as one of the better 6-3 teams out there. It took down A&M. Georgia, though, 8-1. It's a home game. I got the Bulldogs. They've already clinched the SEC spot, SEC East title, but I don't think you'll see Georgia slide any further in terms of their next game. All right, Oklahoma, Oklahoma State. It's Bedlam. Had Oklahoma State not blown it against Baylor, this might have been a fun game, but I got the Sooners in a rout. I don't think the Cowboys put up much of a fight. And then one more game here I want to preview. The Big Ten. Ohio State against a ranked Michigan State program on the road in East Lansing. We've seen Ohio State have some issues so far this year. Could they get into another bit of a pickle against a Michigan State team that has some issues on offense? Maybe it's a trap game for the Buckeyes. Either way, we'll see what happens this weekend. All right, again, folks, that top 25 just came out here on Facebook Live. You're watching Chat Sports Facebook Live, and we'll put this up on YouTube as well. Alabama, Clemson, Notre Dame, Michigan, and Georgia. Oklahoma, West Virginia slides up. The Buckeyes stand pat. LSU drops 5 spots. And Washington State stays at 10, which means UCF still undefeated. And I don't think UCF is going to make a run at the CFP. That they don't have the resume. But I don't know how, from an AP pollster perspective, they beat Temple. Washington State barely beats Cal. And you drop UCF behind them. It just doesn't make any sense to me. Kentucky stands pat, and frankly, folks, you'll see throughout this 12 through 25, it's a mess. Kentucky, Syracuse, Utah State, Texas, Fresno, Boston College, SEC schools, some Pac-12 schools. None of those teams are all that good. They're just average to mediocre teams in terms of comparing them to the top end of the top 25, that top 10, top five teams. So these are going to shuffle consistently week in, week out. Penn State drops a pretty good chunk there. Michigan State remains there at 6-3. And I do want to bring up this one as well because I'm a little bit perplexed by it. Michigan State beat Penn State. They have the same record now. Shouldn't Michigan State be ahead of Penn State? Just throwing that one out there. You see they stand pat there at 8, or they move up into the top 25 at 8-1. They're a nice surprise Power 5 school. By the way, folks, this is the AP poll. The CFP committee will release their rankings live here on Chat Sports Facebook, on Chat Sports YouTube, and on Chat Sports Periscope, 7 p.m. Eastern. We will be live as those rankings get revealed to us to see who moves up after LSU lost. Is it Notre Dame? Or maybe Michigan gets into the top 4, or maybe even higher, given the AP, the committee has done some strange things. But folks, that is the AP Top 25. We'll see you guys on Tuesday for the live CFP ranking.